Fate Kaleid Prisma Illya is an amazing series. It is honestly my favorite iteration of Fate. But the thing that makes it really stand out is the movie, Oh Thunder Snow. It is not what you would expect from Kaleid. Fate Kaleid is a magical girl spinoff, and while it's sometimes serious, its focus is more on the fun with a number of pointless slice of life episodes. Though the movie throws all that away and dives into the dark storytelling Fate is known for. Like, spoiler by the way, Sakura is killed right in front of Shirou, and then Shirou is nearly beat to death by Shinji. This is not Kaleid's storytelling. Except it is. Just another side of it. The story of Fate Kaleid is what happens when the ideals of magical girls are thrown against a dark reality. And you can't have this story without both sides. You need the fun moments with friends, which you mostly got with the first three seasons. But then you also need the moments where all hope is gone. That's what Oh Thunder Snow provided. Shirou is a character who has lost everything. He lost his parents when he was young, then his adoptive father passed away. He was able to have a life he was content with him and his sister, but then Mia was taken from him, and then he begins to fall in love with Sakura, and she is killed. This is far darker than what we had seen in the first three seasons of Kaleid, but it would not be Kaleid without this type of storytelling. Illya and her friends' lives are mostly normal. They have fun, they go to the beach, they learn about their friends' weird taste in literature, and it's a life that any kid should have. Sure, there's that whole magical girl thing, but Fate Kaleid makes a big point of showing the characters are having an ordinary life, because these are the moments that really matter. Some of my favorite moments in life are just spending time with friends doing things that aren't really big and filled with meaning. They're just the simple moments everyone should experience. But these are the moments that Miyu couldn't. At first, I found Season 3 to be the worst season of Kaleid, or at least a letdown compared to the first two, because half of the season was pointless comedy. Good comedy, yes, but it didn't have any bigger meaning to it. At least, not until I saw the movie. Oath Under Snow showed that Miyu finding friends and even coming to Illya's world was all because of Shirou fighting for her and risking his life. This was even called out specifically when Shirou was making his wish, and that made the scene so impactful. Shirou was willing to sacrifice everything for his little sister so that she could have a fun life with friends. And through Season 3 of Kaleid, we see that he succeeded. I love when a show can have this type of layered storytelling, when you see the events, but there's something else on top of them. Oath Under Snow is a prequel that you're supposed to watch after the rest of Kaleid. So, you know how the story here is going to end. Maybe not exactly, but you know the gist of it. Miyu comes to Illya's world. Shirou is captured only to be reunited with Miyu later. So every event in the movie comes with this context. All throughout the battle Shirou goes through, you know he's going to succeed no matter how bad things get for him. And you know they're going to get bad. And that's the beauty of shows like this. The final battle of the movie is also remarkable. It's also one where Shirou wins, but also loses. Angela overpowers him, but even so, he's able to accomplish his goal. Not to mention how well it channels everything Fate about the Kaleid series, while still doing its own thing. Watching the movie especially felt like I was watching Heaven's Feel, but with an extra lolly and a few things thrown in from Unlimited Blade Works. The core of Shirou's character is the desire to be a hero of justice, to save everyone, but coming to grips with the fact that he can't. In Kaleid's case, he instead chooses to be a hero for the one person he cares about. There's also that whole thing with Sakura and how she and Shirou are growing close together, which feels like Heaven's Feel. There's also the fact that I really wanted to see Shinji die a horrible death. Again, like, actually like all of Fate, not just Heaven's Feel, but mostly Heaven's Feel. There are also all the parallels with UBW during the battle between Shirou and Angela. It felt like this movie was just a big tribute to Fate. But any discussion of Oh Thunder Snow would be incomplete without talking about Season 4 as well. Throughout the video, I talked about how Seasons 1 and 3 were mostly lighthearted fun, which they were. But I've glossed over Season 4 because that's when the show started to change, with the main focus being on Illya and her friends rescuing Miyu, and this is also where we see Shirou teaming up with the rest of the cast. Like, that battle with Shirou and fighting Angela was amazing. When I first watched the fight, it was very cool. But this is also the point where the context of Oh Thunder Snow makes it better. With the context in mind, we know that Shirou is fighting against someone far stronger than him. And that while he's determined, that's not enough for him to win. Though with Kuro's help, he's able to take Angela down. And that's really symbolic. Shirou alone cannot save Miyu. but with the help of all of Mia's friends she made because of him, they can win. I feel like the show is sort of being more meta here, with a statement on the nature of what Fake Kaleid is. If you watch Fake Kaleid for the dark storytelling feat, you'll be disappointed. Sure, it's there and done quite well at times, but as good as Oh Thunder Snow is, it's not as good at being a dark fantasy as, say, like Fate Zero or Heaven's Feel. Where Kaleid does something better than any other series I've seen is how it combines the dark storytelling with the fun, magical girl storytelling. Again, you need both aspects, and this battle really shows that. You need the battle of hardened Shirou, but you also need a Loli who reveals more skin than is really necessary. And together, these two were able to overcome a powerful enemy. Those last few episodes of Season 4 were just filled with what makes the show as a whole so special. Though it's been a while since I watched or read those, so I'll save more discussion of those for another time. Yeah, I never would have thought that Fate and Magical Girl anime could come together so well. And now I want Season 5 in more now. Hopefully someday we'll get that. And hopefully someday we'll get that OVA accurately released so I can watch it. If you know about that being out, please let me know. Anyway, thank you for watching this video, which is made as part of the 12 Days of Anime. Tomorrow I will be here with another video over something that really stood out to me this year. Actually, it might have been the opposite of that, and stuff that did not stand out to me. Anyway, look forward to that. And if you want to learn more about the 12 Days of Anime, check the links in the description below.